Mosaic Project. The title really comes from collaborating with many different artists, a lot of different singers, so every song has a different texture. And also there's various styles of music represented on the project, even though it's all under the umbrella of jazz. Just like mosaic artwork, you combine many different shapes and colors to create one big picture. Well, this is more like one big musical picture.
Let's see what that sounds like. That's where the new changes would work.
Okay. I've always believed that music should reflect life. Over the years, people have asked me to do female-driven projects, whether it be in the studio or live shows. I love playing with people of different generations, people of different cultural backgrounds, men and women. But this particular project really is to celebrate women artists, women musicians, instrumentalists, and singers. This is my fifth CD as a leader, and really with all of my CDs, I've assembled casts, some might say all-star casts. Transformations. One thing that's very cool to have Nona on the CD, because she's not known as a jazz singer, it's not really what she does.
She's one of the most soulful singers I know, and to be able to put this jazz arrangement around her voice, I think is very interesting.
Wow. Why am I here? Why am I here is because I'm really blessed that Terry thought of me to be a part of this project.
The most obvious element is that we're all women, and there have been a lot of attempts at making, like, girl jazz bands, as they say.
When she came on the scene, she really broke some ground being female playing it, because now nobody can have in their mind that women aren't as strong on that instrument anymore. Esperanza plays bass on the record, but she also sings on a couple of songs. She sings a haunting melody on a piece that Jerry Allen wrote called Unconditional Love.
It's just powerful music. These are like heavy musicians who have played with the best.
Everybody on this project is a friend, and I think they also felt like it was a valid musical statement for us all to come together and do this.
I met Terry Lynn Carrington when she was 10 years old.
I met her at the Wichita Jazz Festival in 1976. I was playing with Clark Terry.
And here was little Terry Lynn Carrington on the drums. You could barely see her on the drums, but you could hear her. And I remember Buddy Rich just went absolutely crazy when he heard her. She has a beautiful artistic voice. And basically she picked the songs that she thought that would be good for each of the singers to sing. And she picked Echo for me, which I thought was really wonderful. And then she arranged it accordingly. When I heard it, I knew it was for me.
I asked Angela Davis to write something for Echo as an introduction.
We inhabit our histories, and our histories inhabit us.
She's very passionate about the conditions and problems in the prison system in the U.S. So what she wrote definitely speaks on that. It's very brief, but it's very powerful.
Terry has a concept with me because we have worked together for many years.
I came up with the bass line first. And then I said, well, that's 11-4, and even though 11 in itself is very tricky to some people.
But when she sprang this song on me,
I really want to impose a 12-8 feeling on top of it.
I couldn't get all of the rhythmic changes. I was not a happy camper when we were in the studio, and I did fuss at her the whole time we were doing that song.
It became kind of tricky, but...
But that's what Terry Lynn does to you. She will take you places that you think you can't go. She'll challenge you.
It captured the feeling I wanted, a very psychedelic feeling.
And when we're together, we love to challenge each other, so I guess it's tit for tat. What about the way
you love me? This is my favorite Al Green track, and I just thought it would be great to do a Cassandra Wilson-style arrangement on this classic song.
The song itself was, it's daunting, you know. The idea of doing an Al Green piece is scary in itself because he's legendary and it's really difficult to cover him. But the arrangement is just so hot.
I just hoped and prayed that she liked it too. And I sent her to her, and she did.
The texture of it is just so beautiful that it's so different from the original that I was really happy to be a part of it and to put my thing on it. Simply beautiful.
Gretchen Parlato is really one of the premier young jazz vocalists. Every song on the CD I arranged with the voice of the singer in my head. And I Got Lost in His Arms, I arranged thinking about Gretchen.
It's definitely kind of a history in the making, I can feel.
I know that she had gone to the Monk Institute, and her being Hancock and Wayne Shorter were both involved with the Monk Institute, spoke so highly of her that I knew she was bad before I even heard her.
Originally, Shirley Horn had done this song, and she did it so slow and so beautifully that I was like, how do I put a spin on this?
We're about to do this track that is a really cool arrangement that she did of a standard.
And so let's just add a real harder groove and some rock guitar and this soft, piercing voice, which is what Gretchen has.
I got lost in his arms and I had to stay. It was dark in his arms and I lost my way. From the dark came a voice and it seemed to say, there you go.
I wrote Magic and Music in honor of Tina Marie. She was a very close friend, and this was my way of getting through her passing.
Person, and she is an awesome, awesome drummer. One day, when I grow up, I want to be just like her. She kills the drums. I talk about her all the time.
Lots and lots of notes, but great ones. Great. She wrote some good ones. Good ones.
I am here because Terry Lynn and I love to play together, and it's really fun to be part of this project that is all great musicians who happen to be women.
We've just been playing together in a lot of different situations for, I don't know, a couple of decades, maybe.
Well, it's really a dream for me to play this music. It's soulful and it's jazz and it's lyrical and it's groovy.
But I think we need to do Mosaic. Mosaic.
It's Terry Lynn's peeps, it's Terry Lynn's music, so it's all gonna be great.
From a sister to another funky sister.
I dare any man to try to do this right here. What?
Come on.
Any man. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
That's
I
right.
Dare you. This right here. Woo, powerful. Y'all don't understand, but you do. It's all good. We love you anyway.
We love you.
We live, we love, we ride, we die for one another. Transformation needs some transportation. Escape into my mind, slow down my heart racing. Inhale, fill my lungs with songs on my tongue. Repent all my wrongs, nail my battles to the cross. I surrender every breath, prepared to lose it all. I rise for the win, I rise for the fall. What you gonna claim, the beginning or end? Are you born to die, are you born again? Ying, yang, ying, peep the scene, pretty young thing. Eyes bright, bling, she can have anything. Diamonds and pearls, should she be the girl? And prepared to lose it all, I rise for the win, I rise for the fall. What you gonna claim, the beginning or end? Are you born to die? Are you born again? Yin, yang, yin, peep the scene, pretty young thing. Eyes bright, bling, she can have anything. Diamonds and pearls, should she be the girl in the palm of her hand?